Okay guys, welcome to my blind playthrough, let's play, etc. of Undertale. I am the RPG chick. I hope you enjoy this. Please do not post spoilers as I am, you know, going through the game blind, and I wish to experience it blind for all of you, so all the surprises and all the fuddling with gameplay will remain intact. So we got instructions. I can mostly play this. I use a tactical board. For those who don't know what it is, just look up Thrustmaster tactical board. I can pretty much control the entire game except for Enter, which is a Z key, which technically I can press that, but it's probably easier just for me to press Enter on the keyboard since it's right there. But otherwise, yeah, we're looking good. Otherwise, yeah, joystick config. Config. Do not need. Now, does cancel work here? No, I have to go down. Exit here. Name the fallen human. So we do not know if this is male or female or otherwise. But I'm gonna say male for my game at least, since I tend to name my character Amethyst in a lot of my games. I'm gonna name him Garnet. Why not, gosh darn it? It's too bad I can't just type this in with the keyboard. But we're in a way, yeah, emulating. Like, I don't know. Nintendo, SNES, something like that. So, quit backspace done. Is the name correct? As it flips out, Garnet! See? Right. So I can walk around with this. There's my item. Well, I don't have an item. Unfortunately, yeah, I have to enter there. Or stat. Level 1, 20 out of 20 hit points. Next level is in 10. We have a stick. And a bandage. Doing great. I thought X was that. Okay, so it's this, and this. So it could be either. Oh, it can be either. It just wouldn't. So, get out of that, and then it only works like that. Oh, that's weird. Never mind, guys. Never mind. So, anyway. Odd is that there's no settings or anything in this game. There's nowhere to set, change graphic settings. This is pretty much it. There's nowhere to change the subtitles or the sound, so I just have to use the volume mixer in Windows to move the sound down to 40% so you can actually hear me talk over it. Interesting. Now, I have played up to, for those who know, it's not really a spoiler, I guess. There's a ghost that blocks the way, so I've gotten up to that. Just got him to move out of the way, that kind of thing. So otherwise, completely blind here.
Howdy! I'm Flowey! Flowey the Flower! You're new to the underground, aren't you? Golly! You must be so confused! Someone ought to teach you how things work around here. I guess little old me will have to do. Ready? Here we go. See that heart? That is your soul, the very culmination of your being. And I can move it around. Your soul starts off weak, but can grow strong if you gain a lot of LV. LV-426? What's LV stand for? Why, love, of course. You want some love, don't you? Don't worry, I'll share some with you. Down here, love is shared through little white friendliness pellets. Are you ready? Move around. Get as many as you can. We're not actually supposed to do that. Hey, buddy, you missed them. Let's try again, okay? This is the part where people complain that this part isn't blind. Because I know it's coming. I'm sure there are plenty of surprises, though. I do apologize. I had to get a feel for the game, so I'm not completely inept. And, you know, sound levels and all that kind of stuff. Is this a joke? Are you brain dead? Run into the bullets, or friendliness bullets. You know what's going on here, don't you? You just wanted to see me suffer. Die. No. What a terrible creature, torturing such a poor, innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. There's a lot of lines with her, at least so far, and I'm sure I'm going to see her again past where I played, so I really don't want to do a voice of her the entire time, because I'll probably end up... It'll change, you know, and... never mind. Do not be afraid, my child. I am Toriel, caretaker of the ruins. I pass through this place every day to see if anyone has fallen down. You are the first human to come here in a long time. Come! I will guide you through the catacombs. This way. But I want to go this way. I can't go this way. I'm already loving the music in this game. Now, if you were hurt in that battle, this will restore health, and I think also serves as a save point. The shadow of the ruins looms above, filling you with determination. HP fully restored. Empty, right? No, I can't change... Yeah, I guess the dashes mean nothing. I'd like to enter something there, but... We cannot do so. I mean, let's look at this. Okay. Now, that sign says something, I think? I can't read it, though. Welcome to your new home, innocent one. I hope she doesn't betray me at some point as well. Allow me to educate you in the operation of the ruins. Now, I know I tried to read that sign, but I guess I can't because it's so far ahead. I don't know. There are plenty of signs, though, that we can read shortly. The ruins are full of puzzles. Ancient fusions between diversions and door keys. One must solve them to move from room to room. Please adjust yourself to the sight of them. Thank you. I am
well adjusted. Only the fearless may proceed. Brave ones, foolish ones, both walk not the middle road. Can't do anything there, but we can walk over this stuff. To make progress here, you will need to trigger several switches. Do not worry, I have labeled the ones that you need to flip. Press Z to read signs. I'd rather press Enter. Stay on the path. Stay on the path! The path of righteousness. The first switch is over on the wall. Do you need some help? Press the switch on the wall. Come on, you can do it! I like to see if there's additional, you know, dialogue, but nope. Very good, little one. Go on, press the switch on the left. You do know which way left is, do you not? Press the switch that I labeled for you. I do not know my right from left. No, no, no! You want to press the other switch. I even labeled it for you. Splendid! I am proud of you, little one. Let's move to the next room. So, I don't know, she's like some kind of cow thing, or... or perhaps part demon. I don't know. As a human living in the underground, monsters may attack you. You will need to be prepared for this situation. However, worry not. The process is simple. When you encounter a monster, you will enter a fight. While you are in a fight, strike up a friendly conversation. Because yeah, that's the first thing I do when I'm in a fight. Stall for time. I will come to resolve the conflict. Practice talking to the dummy. Does it say I will resolve? Or it will? Do you need some ideas for conversation topics? Well, I often start with a simple, how do you do? You could ask them about their favorite books. Jokes can be useful for breaking the ice. Listen to this one. What did the skeleton tile his roof with? Shingles! Well, I thought it was amusing. Got any more jokes? Practice talking to the dummy. You can say anything. The dummy will not be bothered. I was hoping she had more jokes. Alright. You encountered the dummy. How? I'm not sure. Check or talk. So this gives you stats. Attack 0, defense 0. A cotton heart and a button eye. You are the apple of my eye. This doesn't say anything. Dummy stands around absent-mindedly. You talk to the dummy. It doesn't seem much for conversation. Toriel seems happy with you. You won! You earned 0 XP and 0 gold! Yay! I've never had that much. Ah, very good. You are very good. I can't do anything more with that. There is another puzzle in this room. I wonder if you can solve it. So do I. I tried to hit enter when I was right after. Froggit attacks you! Ribbit. What's going on down below, Froggit? Oh, I don't want to fight. Wait. Oh, he attacks! Wait. Oh, I still have a chance. Okay. Compliment. Where are my compliments? Froggy didn't understand what you said, but was flattered anyway. That's nice of him. Nah. You won! I earned so much gold and experience. My god. Thanks for, you know, getting me out of that. I don't know what I would have done. The Western Room is the Eastern Room's blueprint. Right, so what you see here... you have to repeat here. This is the puzzle, but... here, take my hand for a moment. Now this would be annoying if I had to do it otherwise. It's cute the way she looks back at me like that. Puzzles seem a little too dangerous for now. See, now, it doesn't actually hurt me. So this, in effect, is not a hard puzzle. Just wait till later with the freaking trap doors and stuff. You have done excellently thus far, my child. However, I have a difficult request to ask of you. Uh-oh. I would like you to walk to the end of the room by yourself. Forgive me for this. I don't know what the whole deal with this is. I mean, when I was playing this the first time, I knew where she was, so this isn't like... I'm just literally replaying this. I'll show you guys. I already knew she was behind that, because I went up and... Greetings, my child. Do not worry, I did not leave you. I was merely behind this pillar the whole time. Yeah, no kidding. Thank you for trusting me. However, there was an important reason for this exercise. Yeah, she does tell you. I guess it makes sense. To test your independence. I must attend to some business, and you must stay alone for a while. Please remain here. It's dangerous to explore by yourself. It's dangerous to go alone. I have an idea. I will give you a cell phone. If you have a need for anything, just call. How do you guys get reception down here? Be good, all right? Right, so the cell phone... do all this stuff and bother her. Let's say hello. Dialing. This is Toriel. You only wanted to say hello? Well then. Hello. I hope that suffices. Hehe. Click. How rude. Ask her about herself. This is Toriel. You want to know more about me? Well, I'm afraid there is not much to say. I am just a silly little lady who worries too much. And hangs up. Rudely. This is Toriel. Huh? Did you just call me Mom? Well, I suppose. Would that make you happy? To call me Mother? Well then, call me whatever you like. I'm gonna call you late to supper. Now this is weird, being I've just called her Mother, so we've got some kind of Oedipal complex going on. Huh? Oh, heh. How adorable. I could pinch your cheek. You could certainly find better than an old woman like me. And then hangs up, because I'm a creeper. Alright, let's go. Yeah, that's its balls. Look at that. His balls are swinging back and forth. Unless there's another little creature under him. No, I'm pretty sure that's his balls. Hello? This is Toriel. You have not left the room, have you? No, absolutely not. I have not left the room. There are a few puzzles ahead that I have yet to explain. Okay, Toriel, see you there. It would be dangerous to try to solve them yourself. I'd never think of it. Be good, alright? Click. Now, I don't have any loot options. Yeah, I can just flirt with her again. Oh dear, are you serious? And if you said you want to call me mother! Yep, I'm a freak. Garnet is a freak. You're an interesting child. That's interesting, it didn't work the first time. I guess the, dialogue stuff got saved after I left the room. I'll say hello again? Salutations! Is that enough? Does she keep having... Are you bored? I should have given a book to you. My apologies. Why not use your imagination to divert yourself? Pretend you are a monarch. Rule over the leaf pile with a fist of iron. Can you do that for me? Nope. No can do. Hello, my child. Sorry, I do not have much to say. It was nice to hear your voice, though. Just wondering how many times. Okay, that's it. Pulled the string enough times. Ribbit, ribbit. Which means, excuse me, human. I have some advice for you about battling monsters. If you act a certain way or fight until you almost defeat them, they might not want to battle you anymore. If a monster does not want to fight you, please, use some mercy, human. Ribbit. Well, we can save there after this. Wimson approached meekly. I don't know what this thing is exactly. Some kind of ghost with wings and antenna, and he's crying. It's the most pathetic thing I've ever seen. Cute, though. Let's console Wimson. Wimson? Halfway through your first word, Wimson bursts into tears and runs away. So I didn't win anything. Playfully crinkling through the leaves fills you with determination. HP fully restored. Yay! Now, I don't know what's through there. I don't remember anyway. Oh, I remember. Yeah, it's nothing much. I don't... You know? I think when I was playing this, I don't think I ever went through there. Froggit hopped close. Well, he was standing right there. Flattered anyway. Blushes deeply. Ribbit. Froggit seems reluctant to fight you. Got 2 gold. Alright, what's to here? Oh yes, I did go here. It says, take one. Take a piece of candy? Yes. You took a piece of candy. I know how to open the menu. Take one. Take a candy. Yes. You took more candy. How disgusting. You take another piece. You feel like the scum of the earth. You took too much too fast. The candy spills onto the floor. Look what you've done. Wimson again. If I fight him, I can get some, like, experience and stuff, right? I don't know what that... Okay. Sniff, sniff. Oh, that's easy. It's starting to smell like lavender and mothballs. I still didn't get anything. Alright. Now this... If you go there, you just end up back on that side. I'm pretty sure there's no way other way across there. Ah! Alright, so, yeah. But if you take this way, you end up on the other side. Hello? This is Toriel. For no reason in particular, which do you prefer? Cinnamon or butterscotch? And this is funny because I actually do like both. Cinnamon. Oh, I see. Thank you very much. Click. And then she calls again. You do not dislike butterscotch, do you? I know what your preference is, but... Would you turn up your nose if you found it on your plate? Right, right. I understand. No, I'd actually eat it too. Thank you for being patient, by the way. Three out of four gray rocks recommend you push them. Hello, Froggit. That's how you do it. Oh, this is a major pain in the butt. Pretty sure you go this way, all the way to the bottom, and then this way. Yeah, not that far. Please don't step on the leaves. A pair of froggets. You know, I wonder if I avoided the leaves completely if I could have passed overhead with no problem. Okay, so Froggit. Well, I choose Froggit A, I think. The other one says meow. I got hit. You are intimidated by Froggit's raw strength. Only kidding. Only one. Get rid of one. Oh! Froggit doesn't seem to know why it's here. It doesn't want mercy, though. Flattered, etc. Reluctant, I guess. 4 gold, nice. This reminds me a lot of the Star Trek The Next Generation game I was playing for Genesis. The part with the columns. You guys, you know, if you saw the episodes. Or at least the second to last episode. You had to actually move in a certain way, like the way I'm doing, and the columns would, like, let you through. That kind of thing. Didn't you read the sign downstairs? Now, if you move... east from here, you fall. And there you fall. I've almost got it, though. hog it. I complimented his balls. That's what they call bullet hell, guys. I hope it doesn't get that much harder. And I got candy, though. Check out all this candy I got. All that monster candy. Oh, that's right. So if I go here, I can get info. Monster candy heals 10 hit points, has a distinct non-licorice flavor. Yet at 1.8 one, it said it tasted like licorice. Okay, so we go here, we go here, we go up here, we go to the leaves, and then maybe we go here? No. So close, though. And of course, you're getting the random battles along the way. Here's Wimpson. I get rid of Wimpson quickly. Wow, we gotta call in an episode soon. Alright, next save point. I have to save the game. Nope, there's one there too. Oh, I think I have to go all the way back down and then back up. And I've played through it before. I'll be glad when I save past it. I don't want to go back to the other point. Yeah, yeah, Wimpson. I suppose if I fought him some other way, I could get some gold or experience points or both, but... Got it. This part is funny. Froggit and Wimpson. Get rid of him quickly. Froggit hops to and fro. Rabbit. Ah! Reluctant. Only 2 gold. Yeah, I was wondering. It always is this bottom one. I thought it might be just the last one I pushed. Who starts talking to you? Well there, partner. Who said you could push me around? Hmm? So you're asking me to move over? Okay, just for you, pumpkin. Let's just move this one first. Deal with him. Hmm? You want me to move some more? Alrighty, how's this? It's funny, he moves with it. Hmm? That was the wrong direction? Okay, think I got it. Was that helpful? Not helpful. I wasn't even clicking him before. And then he was a... Hmm? You wanted me to stay there? You're giving me a real workout. Aren't things easier when you just ask? Oh no. Croak, croak. I don't know why you'd be flattering, you can't understand me. Ah! Getting rich over here. Alright, save point. Knowing the mouse might one day leave its hole and get the cheese. It fills you with determination. Beep, beep. And this cheese has been here quite a long time. It's stuck to the table. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Very much enjoying this. We're almost up to the part where, I've played up to. So after that, I'll be completely blind. The ghostie is ahead somewhere. A couple rooms. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.